Out of all the demographics affected by the 2020 coronavirus pandemic, the elderly are perhaps the most vulnerable. Quarantine has profoundly affected the lives of my grandparents. They live in a retirement community in Oceanside, California. Their cozy apartment complex lies about a quarter mile away from the beach.
我们现在的生活和过去的生活还是有比较大的变化，就是过去的话每天大家的话都热热闹的了，是吧？要是散步的话，很多人在集中一起走，是吧？这个每天的话呢，跑到皮尔上面去钓鱼，钓几个钟头的鱼。我们过去散步的话呢，这个是在皮尔上面散步，现在的话呢，就改成这个比较僻静的道路散步，是吧？这样的尽量的话呢，不可能接受。
现在我们呢就死带红，就待在家里。去年的这个时候呢，我是在那个图书馆那边去学的那个英文，那个是从上午9、10点到11点半，在每天去，在有时候呢在图书馆里还可以借几本那个小朋友小孩子看的那种书。
Every few weekends, my mom and I fill a cooler with groceries and Asian snacks to bring to my grandparents. Since quarantine started in March, my grandparents have avoided shopping in person, so we bring over our delivered goods. My parents also help my grandparents with technology issues as well as tasks requiring English skills. They're always happy to have visitors, as the apartment can feel isolated at times. My grandparents' favorite pastime, and incidentally the safest in a pandemic, is cooking. They typically cook a large lunch of Chinese food and save the leftovers for dinner. The familiar smell of Chinese food truly makes the apartment home. Sometimes, when they're feeling fancier, my grandparents will make Chinese dumplings from scratch. It's a common activity for my family members to do together, so we help out during our visits. We roll the dough, fold around the meat, and then boil the dumplings for a delicious lunch. These traditional meals remind my grandparents of their home back in China. They immigrated from China after I was born here, and mostly speak Mandarin. Still, my grandparents maintain a lot of independence. Before the coronavirus, they would travel everywhere by bus or train. Nowadays, it's too crowded to be safe. Instead, they have to rely on my parents to drive. Of course, we can only visit on the weekends, so their independence is a little bit more limited now. We bring our dog Ruby and drive my grandparents to less crowded areas outside of the city. My grandparents still love to go hiking, and we're happy to tag along. Even with the pandemic going on, they still maintain the same active lifestyle as before. These trips are a little less frequent because of the risk, but they're careful to wear masks and avoid other hikers on the trail. On the rare occasion my grandparents do go to the pier, it's always early in the morning. The tourists haven't arrived yet, so my grandfather can do his favorite pre-coronavirus activity, fishing off the side of the pier. I'm amazed to see how my grandparents are adapting to the pandemic. They put in a lot of effort to reclaim some semblance of a normal pre-quarantine life. Every day, the news grows more dire. Coronavirus has now affected over 11 million people in the US. And yet, my grandparents know that the best thing to do is to stay safe and find a routine. The pandemic also has a way of isolating people, forcing us to figure out what's important and whom we really need to see. In this aspect, my grandparents are a bit lucky. They've always been very independent, and their friend circles are mostly back in China. My grandparents have quickly adapted to the quarantine lifestyle. Oceanside looks completely different than a year ago, but I know my grandparents will always find a way to enjoy life, even if it's as simple as watching a sunset over the ocean.